Greetings and salutations! This is Evelyn O'Malley, Lady of the Realm, and this video is dedicated to the 7 people you meet in middle school. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, just like the 7 people you meet in heaven and in hell, I'm sure you meet a lot of people in hell too, depending on kind of person you are. Or unless you're atheist and you don't believe in a hell, then, well, forget you then. Anyways, I would like to start off with the first kind of person you meet. The lovable, yet, well, okay, maybe not just middle school, high school as well. Just so, you know, you don't run into it. To be honest, this list is just about people who were my best friends in high school. And these are just the people you meet while you're there. And I like to start off with one being the annoying quirky person. And this guy goes by the name, well, for this particular situation, Patrick. This guy tends to love talking about certain things, like how you can erase, how the speed of light works, and he enjoys games like Punch Buggy, and he loves to smell Old Spice. His deodorant and soap. But he's a good guy. He's intelligent. He knows a lot about certain things, but just don't let him do the Hitler salute. I apologize to those people out there who are Jews and who are viewing this channel right now, but this kind of person exists. Sorry. Hey. But yeah, they're not always thoughtful of what they're doing, so. The second one, and this one I met around the same time, him, and this guy goes by the name of Che. Not giving his last name, okay, but he can be annoying. He's also known as a beggar. This guy bugs you about everything. He begs for attention. He begs for food. He makes weird noises that only a chipmunk could make. Hank, on steroids. Yes. Well, I mean, on steroids, it sounds like the wrong. Okay. He also likes to clown around with another guy by the name of Caleb. And he counts as the third person you meet in middle school and at high school. And the reason why I mention this guy as a separate as well as a second is because they usually come in pairs. This guy is a jerk. A jerk. A complete jerk. He sides with the beggar every single freaking time, too. But, you know, you put up with it anyways. Yes. Okay, now on to the fourth person you meet in elementary school and high school. And this person, I like to call, might be a good description for this person. I guess is the depressed, lonely person. And the problem with this person is, this is a person who tells you, whenever you're cleaning up or picking up pieces of trash, even if you're in a place where there's a lot of trash anyways, so it's like, what's the point? Or, you know, you see a bunch of scuff marks on the floor, and they tell you, why do you keep doing that? You know, it's dirty. Leave it alone. He's out for the janitor. He's not lazy enough, isn't he? This person has a reason for her depression, but it can get a little wearing. But not that you dislike them. You actually kind of go, well, they're only human. They don't always know what they're thinking or saying. But you love them anyways. And there can be reasons for this depression, like any other depression. This person is probably depressed about a family member. And, you know, you feel for this person because you want to help them, but you know the help that that person can get might require leaving. You know? And just sitting there. And for the time being, before that person leaves, just kind of sit there and let them talk, let them blow off steam, and just be like, yeah, you know, you don't really get to you much. Just let them talk. Because, you know, you might be the last person they ever talk to. So. I think I presented, okay, this is the fifth one. And this one, let's put it this way. This one I like to call the overachiever. Yes, the overachiever. This person, albeit she has a lot of high hopes, and I mean very high hopes, she loves to drag you along with her on the ride. She's the definition of that girl from Living La Vida Loca. The only difference is they got the facial descriptive parts wrong, but they got the mentality correct. But the difference is, this is the person who denies that Islam is a religion, yet will tell you, well, maybe you should have been nicer to me. Karma's a bitch. Attitude, isn't it? You know, she's a two-faced pain in the ass, but you continue to be friends with her because you don't want this person to kill you in the middle of the night. That person knows exactly who she is, or who he or she is. And if he or she is watching this video, hopefully he or she has learned this lesson by now. Oh. And hopefully you won't run into this person ever again. And okay. Now, on to the sixth one. And this one I met in both my elementary school years and in my middle school through high school years, I guess. Yeah. And this one is kind of a twofer because, like I said, this one I like to call the pleasant, well, I guess the two-faced hypocrite. The only difference is, yeah, she smiles in your face and then does something to someone else behind your back. She usually bullies your friends, you know, she's kind of not nice to your, you know, you might have had a friend who was a sibling to this person and to that person that you like, and she's not very nice in the background and or at home when she's around, which, you know, arguably is like, hey, she's not mean to me, so I can't really get upset about it, but it's a lot harder to be her friend knowing that she's doing this stuff. Oh. And most of the time you continue to be her friend in spite of that. But even though she's mean to those people, As long as she's nice to you, all is gravy. And not that big of a deal. And then finally, and this one, like I said, I didn't write this one down or anything. I just thought this one up on my own. And all of these really are, and I would probably say this is the 7th one that you meet. And this would be titled The Really Cool Guy. And, you know, he's a smart guy. He shows you things that are about politics and stuff. But, you know, unlike most people who show you politics, he's not so pompous about it. He doesn't think he knows everything. He just knows a lot about this subject. He's a nice guy. He doesn't hate you. He doesn't hate anybody. He's just sweet. And you develop a crush on this person. You like this person. You talk with this person. And a lot. And you wish you could go farther, but you don't, because it's the last day of school, and, well, that's just life, folks. And at the same time, when you do make the advance, like anyone else, you know, you cause a little stir. You talk with them, you want to tell them, but you don't want to ruin the current friendship that you have. So, yeah, you try to do it the subtle way, if you get what I mean. And he's gone. And you try to figure out, maybe again, one day I'll meet this person. But there's probably a strong possibility you won't. Anyways, please subscribe down below. Follow me on my Tumblr and Twitter. The links are down in the description if you wish to. And thank you for watching this video. Like I said, I'll continue with this series of Happy Birthday to Me, and it'll be on my site where you can continue to watch it and laugh at my stupidity and what I did and what I didn't do when I was a kid or what I'm still doing as a young adult. Anyways, see you later, folks.